We want to expand the quantity 5x minus 2 raised to the fourth power using the binomial theorem as well as Pascal's triangle. If we take a look at the binomial theorem, it can be expressed using summation notation or an expanded notation as we see here. And notice if we take a look at each term in the expansion, each term has a factor that's a combination, highlighted here in pink, as well as a factor involving x, the first term in the binomial, and a factor of y from the second term of the binomial. As we look at our example, you'll see the pattern in this that will make it much easier to remember. In this video, to evaluate the combinations, instead of using factorials, as we did in some of the previous examples, we're going to use Pascal's triangle, given here below, where if the binomial is raised to the nth power, if we find row n in Pascal's triangle, it'll give us the value of each combination. If you want to know more information about how this triangle is formed, I'll put a link on the screen for a video that will go over this in more detail. So if we go back to our example, notice how our binomial is raised to the fourth power, which means our first term will have the combination 4 choose 0. And then because the first term in the binomial is 5x, we'll have 4 factors of 5x. And the second term is negative 2, so we'll have 0 factors of negative 2. So we started with 4 choose 0, and then we have 4 factors of 5x and 0 factors of negative 2. And then for the next term, we'll have 4 choose 1. And now we'll only have 3 factors of 5x. So we have 5x to the third. And we'll start picking up factors of negative 2, so we'll have negative 2 to the first. And then for the third term, we'll have 4 choose 2. And then we'll have 5x to the second and negative 2 to the second. Notice if we add these exponents, each time they sum to 4, which is the original exponent on our binomial. And then for the next term, we'll have 4 choose 3. And we'll have only 1 factor of 5x and 3 factors of negative 2. And now for the last term, we'll have 4 choose 4. And we'll have 0 factors of 5x and 4 factors of negative 2. So we've now applied the binomial theorem. So the next step is to simplify each term in the expansion. And as mentioned earlier, to evaluate the combinations, we're going to use Pascal's triangle. And since the original binomial is raised to the fourth power, we can find the value of each combination in row 4 of Pascal's triangle, where the first row here is row 0. So we have row 0, row 1, row 2, row 3, and finally row 4. Another way to check to make sure that we have the correct row is notice that this row has 5 numbers, and our expansion has 5 combinations. Therefore, 4 choose 0 is equal to 1, 4 choose 1 is equal to 4, 4 choose 2 is equal to 6, and so on. So again, 4 choose 0 is equal to 1, so we'll have 1 times 5x to the fourth. Well, 5 to the fourth is equal to 625, so we'll have 625x to the fourth. Negative 2 to the 0 is equal to 1, plus 4 choose 1, which is equal to 4. So we have 4 times 5x to the third. Well, 5 to the third is equal to 125, so we have 125x to the third times negative 2 plus 4 choose 2 is equal to 6, so we have 6 times 5x squared, that would be 25x squared, and negative 2 squared is positive 4, plus 4 choose 3 is equal to 4, so we have 4 times 5x times negative 2 to the third, that's negative 8. And finally, our last term, we have 4 choose 4, that's 1. 5x to the 0, that's 1. And then we have negative 2 to the fourth, which would be positive 16. So we'll simplify this one more time. We have 625x to the fourth. For the next term, we'd have 4 times 125 times negative 2. That's actually negative 1,000 times x to the third. So we have minus 1000x to the third. Next we have 6 times 25 times 4, that's 600, times x to the second, so plus 600x to the second. Next we have 4 times 5 times negative 8, that's negative 160 times x, so minus 160x. And the following we have 1 times 1 times 16, so we have plus 16. This would be the expansion of the quantity 5x minus 2 raised to the fourth. Hopefully we agree that if we recognize the pattern in the binomial theorem, it makes it a lot easier to remember and apply the theorem to expand binomials raised to powers. I hope you found this helpful.